Hello, everyone. Welcome to my presentation of our Q2-22 results. I will give you an overview of the highlights in the quarter and then some more details on our financial figures. Finally, I will give you an update on the development of our business. Let me start by giving you an overview on the key business developments in Q2 on slide two. Demand for our equipment remains dynamic across the board, resulting in an outstanding order situation with an order intake of 153 million for Q2. We have received our first order for the volume production of micro-LEDs, which is very encouraging. In addition to that, demand for our equipment to produce efficient power electronics was again very strong this quarter, with demand for laser tools remaining strong as well. This leaves us with an order backlog of 314 million euros, of which the majority is due for delivery this year. Revenues in the quarter increased by 51% year-on-year to 102 million euros. Gross margin was slightly lower than normal at 37% in the quarter due to a high share of tool deliveries to make traditional red LEDs and some one-time project costs to further optimize our operations. EBIT more than tripled year-on-year to 17 million euros, resulting in a quarterly net profit of also 17 million euros or 0.16 per share due to the further recognition of tax loss carryforwards. Despite the challenging global environment, we can again confirm our original guidance for fiscal year 2022, which we have first given in February of this year, as we are fully on track to achieve what we've guided for in orders, revenues, and profit margins. The orders will remain on high levels, while revenues and margins are expected to be higher in the second half of 2022 versus the first half of the year. In fact, we expect Q3 to be stronger than Q2 and Q4 to be stronger than Q3 in terms of revenues. I'm very glad that today's global crisis situations still do not have a significant impact on our business. Logistics and supply chains are not back to normal. They remain tense but continue to be stable. We are in close exchange with our suppliers and support them wherever required. Now let me give you some more details on our financials on slide number three. Total revenues for the second quarter 2022 were close to 102 million euros, 51% above the same quarter of last year. Gross profit went up by 36% year-on-year to 38 million euros. The gross margin at 37% was influenced by a less favorable product mix and one-time costs for projects to further strengthen our production and supply chains. Both effects were only partially offset by a favorable US dollar-euro exchange rate, which had an influence on slightly more than a third of our revenues as these were US dollar denominated. OpEx in the quarter decreased to 21 million euros from 22 million euros in the same quarter of 2021, mainly due to lower R&D spending resulting from the timing of projects only. Our EBIT in the quarter more than tripled year-on-year to 17 million euros from 6 million the year before. EBIT margin was at 17%. As said before, we again used tax loss carryforwards and capitalized additional deferred tax assets in the amount of around about 2.5 million euros due to expected future profits. We can therefore report a quarterly net profit of 17 million euros, which more than doubled compared to 8 million euros recorded in the same quarter of last year. Turning to the balance sheet on the next slide. Inventories at the end of June 2022 have risen to 162 million euros from 144 million euros at the end of March in preparation for the higher expected business volume in the coming quarters. As part of our supply chain strategy, we also keep some strategic inventories of selected components to maintain our capability to timely deliver our tools to customers. Due to the high end demand supporting our revenue guidance for the year, advanced payments received from customers by the end of June 2022 increased to 104 million euros from 81 million at the end of March, representing about 33% of our backlog. Trade receivables increased to 58 million euros from 50 million at the end of March due to a higher share of shipments at the end of the quarter. Our cash balance, including other financial assets, decreased to 346 million euros at the end of the quarter from 375 million euros at the end of March, the reduction being mainly due to our dividend payment of 34 million euros in May. Moving to our cash flow statement of slide 5. In Q2 of 2022, free cash flow was at 4 million euros compared to 18 million euros in the same quarter last year, mainly due to an increase in inventory and trade accounts receivables combined with a rise in advance payments received for customer orders. Before giving you an updated view on the outlook for the second half of the year, I would first like to give you a quick update on the key developments in some of our addressed markets. In most of our addressed end markets, we continue to see strong momentum. As previously mentioned, have we shipped a sizable number of tools to produce traditional red LEDs, representing the largest share of our Q2 revenues. The second largest contributor were tools shipped for silicon carbide power electronics. The next biggest contributor to Q2 revenues were tools to make datacom lasers for glass fiber networks. Energy-efficient power electronics based on wide bandgap materials continue to be broadly adopted in an increasing number of applications, replacing less efficient silicon. We see that in the orders and revenues for our systems in these areas. In GaN power in particular, the strong momentum continues going far beyond initial customer applications such as chargers. Our customers are already addressing opportunities in applications with, for example, 24/7 operations, such as data centers, base stations, or even household appliances such as refrigerators, just to name a few. The penetration of GaN in all of these areas is increasing. In addition to these applications, we see our customers already looking further ahead towards, for example, towards motor drives or applications in battery electric vehicles. Therefore, we believe strongly that demand will continue driven by the structural demand drivers behind it, namely the energy efficient energy savings offered by efficient GaN power supplies compared to less efficient silicon power electronics. The other wideband material, silicon carbide power, we see our customers building up or expand their capacities based on the fast growing adoption within battery electric vehicles, replacing silicon as material here as well. As we've said before, our new silicon carbide tool for 6- and 8-inch wafers is showing very, very good performance. It offers a very high throughput due to its multi-wafer batch approach in combination with full cassette-to-cassette automation. At the same time, it offers wafer level process control with a high quality output. This makes us strongly believe that we have a highly attractive solution in our portfolio, particularly in comparison to single wafer solutions being offered by competition. The growing acceptance of our technology by existing and new customers confirms our view. In the area of micro LEDs, we're very happy to announce that we have received the first order for the volume production of red, of green, and of blue micro LEDs, needing a particular tool for each of these from our customer. This is very encouraging as this is seen as clear evidence that preparations to develop and launch first commercial products have started. As we have said before, this development makes us increasingly confident that we will see further commercial products with micro LED displays such as TVs, notebooks, or smartphones going forward. With that, let me now give you an update, as said before, on the full year guidance 2022 on slide number 6. Based on the strong business development in the first half and our positive view on the development of the business in the second half of the year, we confirm our growth guidance for the full year 2022 as we originally issued it in February. Including the 283 million euros of orders recorded in the first half, we continue to expect total orders for the year in a range between 520 and 580 million euros. We continue to expect our 2022 revenues to be in a range between 450 and 500 million euros. This is based on the 191 million euros of total revenues recorded in the first half and builds on our equipment order backlog of 314 million, of which a large part is due for delivery during this year. based on the 39% gross margin and the 16% EBIT margin we achieved in the first half, we continue to expect a gross margin of around 41% and an EBIT margin in a range of 21% to 23% due to the stronger margin development expected for the second half of 2022, as said before. And as before, all these expectations for 2022 are subject to the provision that the current global crisis situations around us will again not have a significant impact on the development of our business as it didn't have before. With that, I will conclude my presentation of our Q2 2022 results. We are and we will be addressing the big trends of sustainability, electrification, and digitization with our technologies, and are therefore very confident that we will have a bright future ahead of us. With that, I conclude and say bye-bye.